Hi, I'm Levi.
And I'm Jesse.
And welcome to Green Ridge Metalworks.
Today, we're going to make vise stands for these post vises.
We have one post vise already, and we've built a stand for it. We use it like crazy, and we love it, so we're going to make some for these.
We got both of these from estate auctions. This one was $80, and this one was $20. We got a really good deal on this one.
This one's already been featured in one of our videos. We refurbished it, and if you haven't seen it, you might want to check it out.
I'm going to make mine more modern looking, like the one we already have.
And I'm going to make mine look antique, and I'm going to see if I can make it look as if it came from a turn-of-the-century blacksmithing shop.
So let's get this one cleaned up and ready to go.
Let's get started. We have the whole vise wire wheeled, so now I need to coat it in linseed oil before we put it together. After some research, we figured out that this is a Wilkinson's Queen's Dudley vise. They were an English company in the 1800s, and they made anvils. We don't know much about their post vises because after all the research we did, we couldn't find anything on post vises at all. But this is what it must be because it says Queen's Dudley on the front. I think it'd be easier if we did one vise stand at a time, so me and Jesse are going to rock, paper, scissors to see who goes first. You win.
The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cut the legs to my vise stand. They're going to be made out of pipe. They have to be angled out at 70 degrees, so I have to adjust the saw vise to 70 degrees. So we found this old piece of scrap steel, and it's already the right shape and size, but there's some welds on it. We have to clean those off with the grinder. That's good. Thank you. Okay, so we decided to put a hardy hole right here, a 1-inch square hole used for tooling. And you usually see them on anvils. We're gonna put one in the stand today. We're going to put sand in the three legs, so it will be heavier, it won't make as much noise when we beat on it, and it won't vibrate as bad either. We put the plug in so the sand won't come out the hardy hole. I'm super happy with the end result of the vise stand. It looks amazing. This was my first really big project. My first time on the lathe, and I'm getting a lot better with MIG welding. I think the vise matches well with the vise stand. If you like this video, stick around for part 2, where Levi makes his vise stand. By the way, it's going to be completely different. Please like and subscribe.